Welcome to Life Connect, the place where hopefully life happens and it happens in abundance. And we just want to welcome you, our online audience. It is so great to have you connect with us week in and week out. And you need to know, we consider you part of the family, as much part as anyone else who visits in person. And we really value your commitment to connecting with us. May you be blessed as you connect even more. Now, we're ending a series today called Sun Stand Still. And if you perhaps missed the others, you can view it. You know where already, Facebook, Instagram, or YouTube. Just search Life Connect and you'll find us. And for those of you who don't know me, I'm Paul. And just love doing what God has called me to do, and that is to share His Word. And so I want to share with you about the sun stand still. Now, where we've come from over the previous 3 weeks is Joshua, who is fighting on behalf of the Gibeonites against five of the other kings in the area. And he's busy defeating the enemy, and the sun's busy going down. And by the way, you can read this in Joshua 10 from about verse 7. As the sun's going down, Joshua prays this enormous prayer, and he says, "Sun, stand still, and moon, just stand still over the valley of Ajalon." And as the sun stands still, they've got time to completely annihilate this enemy so they can't form up again and come attack Israel later. God had given them instruction to just, you know, take them out in order to protect Israel. So this is what happened. And so we've been talking around the sun stand still prayer, and we've been asking you to pray the big prayers and trust God for the big things. We spoke in the first week about, you know, you need to hear God's voice, and you need to know how God is answering your prayers and how God is directing your life. And if you can understand, if you can discern God's voice, you'll have sun stand still moments in your life. Let me ask you, step it up, man. Just step it up and start praying these big prayers and trusting God for the things that you maybe haven't trusted Him before, or things you have been praying you haven't seen answers to. Keep going, pray the big prayers, pray them out loud. And then last week we just spoke about briefly how the sun does stand still, but the S-O-N, and how Jesus comes and stands in front of you and me and calls us into a relationship with Him, or calls us to a deeper, higher place in Him. And the deeper you go, the more faith you got, and the bigger your prayers can be. But now, I understand, because I've been in this position where, you know, I'm not getting the answers and I'm not getting the results I expect. And I've often had thoughts like, you know, why bother God with this? And why bother God when He doesn't answer prayers? Because here I am, I'm still battling financially. My child is still sick. My marriage has got worse, not better. Why bother? And we've all got those why bother moments. And we need to deal with it, because I sincerely wish that the things we pray for dramatically change. But it's unlikely that your what about stuff, as Stephen Furtick puts it, that what about stuff, that is going to be resolved instantaneously. More often than not, it's a process. I wish I could say, sun stand still, and you tune out here, or you go home and things are different, that your teenage daughter suddenly stops rolling her eyes and she's volunteering to wash dishes and she realizes her boyfriend's a bad influence. And I sincerely hope those things happen, but they're unlikely. And this raises our why bother questions, or our what about stuff. What about that prayer you didn't answer? What about this situation? And I want to take you to a different portion of Scripture where we've spent the last few weeks in Joshua chapter 10. I want us just to to roll their head a couple of hundred years, 1,000+ years, to Mark chapter 5. And I want to tell you a story about a why bother moment. So let me give you a little bit of background, and you can go read this in Mark 5 from about, I'm just looking here as I'm talking, from about, let's say verse 24, around there. And I want to tell you, no, 22, sorry, verse 22. I want to tell you about a man called Jairus. And he was a leader, he was an esteemed man in the community. He was the leader in the synagogue. That was a big deal. Now what happens is his daughter falls desperately ill. And he knows, always heard the talk, always been a witness to, we don't know, that Jesus is the man. If you've got an issue, he can solve it. If you need a sun stand still moment, you go to Jesus, he makes it happen. So he goes looking for Jesus. And he finds Jesus, and there's this big crowd of people around him. And he puts his case to Jesus. He says, Messiah, teacher, Lord, my daughter's ill. I need you to come pray for her because I'm afraid she's going to die if you don't. Now, you see, that is a sun stand still moment. That's a sun stand still faith right there on display. Like he knows his daughter's busy dying, but he's got the confidence to go to Jesus. And this is why I'm saying, pray those big prayers, but have faith for those big prayers. The more you trust Jesus, the more you see him come through for you, the more your faith will grow. So Jesus agrees and says, okay, let's go do this. I'll come. I see your faith. I see your concern for your daughter. Man, I feel your pain. I'm going to go with you. I'm going to pray for your daughter. And on his way there, there's this whole crowd of people around him. And suddenly, you can go read it. It says he feels the power go out of him. And as he was walking, another woman who needs a sun stand still moment in her life, she has had this issue with blood. Okay? Now, I don't want to get too graphic, but she's been bleeding, menstruating for about 12 years. And she would have been outcast. People would have pushed her one side. She would have been dirty and smelly and the unloved one. But she's got faith. She knew things about this guy called Jesus who was coming by. And she realized, man, if only I can touch the hem of his robe. So I've given a message on this before. It was a wonderful message. But I could imagine her just reaching through this crowd and just touching his robe in complete 100% faith. And it says then Jesus feels this power go out of him. Now you've got to understand there's two things playing out here. This healing, because it said she was healed instantly, and Jairus. This girl is pushing in while his daughter's busy dying. Okay? She just cuts in on him. And he must have been thinking, but man, what's up with this woman? He must have been thinking, my daughter needs Jesus more than this woman. And often we are doing that. We're looking at other people and evaluating other people, thinking, man, they either need Jesus more than we do, or they've got more of Jesus than we do. And both are equally bad, especially if you're comparing your blessing with someone else's life. Thinking, oh, look at that guy. He knows the Bible. Look at that guy. He's so rich. He's blessed. What's wrong with me? Look at these people. Look how they live. Look at that family. And you're comparing yourself because other people are pushing into your sun stand still moment in your life. And you're letting them defeat you. Jairus could have right then said, oh man, this is it's too late now. The stupid woman. But here's what I want to talk to you about. Jairus had to wait till the Lord was ready to move on. And often we got to wait till the Lord is ready to move on into our situations. We want instant. We want now. But the Lord is seated up high. He looks down and He sees the big picture. And you might not see it now, but believe me, He does. And He'll be there right on time. But what's interesting about this, and I want to read this part to you, in verse 32 it says, but Jesus kept looking around to see who had done it. And I think He was just playing along like, who was that? Who was that? He knew, He's Jesus. Then the woman, knowing what had happened to her, she had been healed, came and fell at His feet and trembling with fear, told Him the whole truth. She's talking to Jesus. She's just been healed, folks, from 12 years of anguish. We can't begin to understand what this woman went through. But she feels in that moment the need to tell Him the whole truth. Even though she's been healed, even though she probably knows, Jesus knows what is wrong with me and what has happened to me. Because the power went out of Him. And often in our life, I just wish you and I could tell Jesus the whole truth and not hide away our insecurities or hide away our sins. That we would have these sun stand still moments where we can just open up and say, Lord, here I am, warts and all. This is my issue. This is what I'm battling with. This is where I don't trust You. This is why I haven't built up trust, because Lord, I'm still waiting for an answer to that prayer, or I've been praying for my son or whatever. Let's just get truthful with Jesus and tell Him what's on our heart. The Lord can handle it. She told Him the whole truth. That means she kept nothing back. I don't know how long that would have taken. But old Jairus is standing and he's still waiting for his son stands still moment. And while he's busy chatting to this woman, and Jairus is busy like, Lord, we got to get a move on. Have you seen the time? My daughter's sick. Some people come from his house. And yes, what did they say? Your daughter is dead. There could be things in your life that you feel are dead. Things that you prayed for haven't come to be. Things you were trusting for that are starting to smell because they died long ago. I'm going to tell you today, Jesus is going to be on time for you. In that situation, his daughter was dead. And here's what they followed that up with. Why bother the teacher anymore? Why bother? Lord, You haven't answered my prayer about my child. Lord, I'm still battling illness. Lord, we're still short of money in the house. Lord, I'm still battling with this sin. Why bother? We've got too many Christians, too many believers. Got this why bother attitude. You're not praying the big prayers. You're not standing in faith because you believe you're still suffering the disappointment of unanswered prayers or unfulfilled faith in Jesus Christ. And you're at this point in your life where you just say, why bother? I'll go to heaven one day. So why bother about all the rest? I'll just battle along. I'll just bear the pain. I'll just this, I'll just that. Why bother? And Jesus overhears. And Jesus overhears the echo of your heart as well. It says here in verse 35, overhearing what they said, Jesus told him, don't be afraid, just believe. In some translations it says, he ignored them. He ignored the people who said, why bother? Why bother? She's dead. You can turn around. You can go back home. But he said, or he ignored at least them, the naysayers, those without faith, those who weren't believing for big things. He ignored them. Don't be afraid, he said, just believe. Are you hearing this? Where you are now, you need to hear this. Don't be afraid. Just believe. I want you to mark that in your Bible. Mark 5, verse 35, part B. Why bother the teacher anymore? In verse 36, overhearing what they said, Jesus told them, mark this, don't be afraid, just believe. Just believe. And then what does he do? He says, he did not let anyone follow him. He left the naysayers behind. He left all the negative people behind. And maybe you must start leaving some people behind. You know, we listen to our family members and we listen to our friends. Maybe we should stop listening to them and start listening to what the Lord is saying. Leave some people behind. Don't give them your ears, because what they're speaking is affecting your heart. And it's impacting your situation, because you're in a place now, why bother? Or look at those people. Look at those people. What about poor old me? And Jesus went down to that house. And when he came, there was people crying all over the place. People crying, girl is dead. Girl is dead. We'll learn now, her name is Talitha. Hey, she's dead. And Jesus goes in. And he says, what's up? What's up? What's all this wailing and this commotion? Stop moaning and stop groaning, people. Stand in faith. If you are complaining, you are busy killing the answers of God in your heart. Ah, Lord, may we just have faith in you. Verse 40. But they laughed at him. They laughed at him. I won't be laughing at Jesus, because I've seen Jesus stand still in front of me, and I've seen Jesus stand still in front of some of you. That's no laughing matter. That is falling on your knees and worshiping matter. And if you don't trust Jesus, if you don't push through with his son, stand still prayers and stand in faith for those things, you're not going to get to the place where you realize, I can only but worship the King. You're going to be one of those moaners and groaners and laughers. And we don't want you to be like that. We want you to be a worshiper. So Jesus put them all out, and he healed that little girl. Jesus can do and still does do the sun stand still things. And you need to bother. They asked, why bother? And I'm telling you, you have to bother. Because when you're still bothered, means God can still work, because you haven't cancelled out your request to the Lord by your negative mindset and the condition of your heart. You need to be bothered. You need to be concerned still. You need to be telling the whole truth still. Imagine if Paul, when he was shipwrecked, said, why bother? Imagine if Philip said, why bother? Or Peter, or John, or Moses, or David. Imagine if they said, why bother? We wouldn't have bothered to read what had been written about them, because it wouldn't have mattered. But because they bothered, we can see the work of God, the hand of God, the provision of God, and the answers of God, because they bothered. We need to still trust God. We need to pray big prayers. And when this reasoning of yours wants to set in, where you reason out everything in your life, where was God then? Why isn't this happening? Why is that guy got an I don't have? Why was that person healed? I still got pain. Why is their business blessed and I'm not? As long as you're reasoning things out, you're limiting the impact of God in your life. Guys, girls, ladies, gents, sons and daughters, God loves you. And he does still make the sun stand still for those who believe. And I pray you believe. I really pray you would just believe. And you're going to see miracles in your life. Let's just trust God. Can I pray for you? Lord, we've come before you with the petitions of our heart, the things, Lord, that are causing us fear and insecurity and doubt, Lord. And we've laid them at your feet. And now we stand today in agreement that we believe, and we're not going to say, why bother? We're going to say, I'm holding on to the promises of God, and I'm putting my faith in the Father, because the Father loves me. He cares for me and he provides for me. Help us to stand strong, to stand firm, Lord, and to take decisions that will benefit us and benefit our families. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Power, man, God is good. He's so good. But you only realize his goodness when you allow him to be good in your life by not canceling out his goodness by why bother attitude. Thank you for listening. Thank you for sharing this message. Thank you for blessing and sowing into this ministry. We are so privileged to have you part of us. Till next week, have a good one. God is good, and he's going to be good to you. Amen.